Hi, my name is Sean, and together with my friends Malcolm, Roy, and Kate, we will be discussing on the subject of whether opening of new zoos should be banned worldwide or not.
So, what are zoos? There are many types of zoos, including petting zoos, roadside zoos, safari parks, and aquariums. Zoos are places for study, conservation of animals, and for the public to enjoy. In these places, we get to see exotic animals you will probably never get a chance to see. Have you ever thought how dull your childhood would have been without ever observing and remarking at the beauty of wild animals? That is why it is compulsory for primary school children to visit our Singapore Zoo to view animals and broaden their horizons, helping them understand that we are not the only species on the planet.
In addition, many animals that are kept in captivity have been proven to have a longer life expectancy. They are well cared for and their needs are catered to.
However, zoos do not create an environment in which animals can thrive in because it simply isn't a natural habitat. A habitat that previous generations of their species have adapted to, a habitat that's in their blood to survive in. Hence, are zoos really the best place for animals to grow and develop in?
With this in mind, we shall begin our debate. We will be discussing in the context of the Singapore Zoo, weighing its pros and cons to allow us Singaporeans better relate to the topic before hopefully showing its relevance on a global level. Kit and I will be presenting why we are against the closing of zoos, with Malcolm and Sean supporting the closing of zoos. Shall we begin?
Yes!
I will be presenting why we are against the closing of zoos. Firstly, one of the purposes of zoos are for the conservation. Some zoos are akin to open sanctuaries, providing a place where endangered or almost extinct animals are able to dwell and build up their population in a safe and controlled environment where there are people to take care of them. I believe that if the animals are being treated well and have sufficient room to dwell in, the zoo is a perfect place for the animals to live in. Unlike in the wild, where animals are in constant danger of poaching or natural hunting, zoos provide a safe environment to ensure that the lives of these animals are not threatened. Zoos also have years of research and development that have created breeding programs to help certain species breed and prosper in the controlled environment of the zoo so future generations can enjoy looking at these animals.
An example is the Singapore Zoo. It has had successful breeding programs by hosting exchange programs with other zoos overseas. Their offspring are then sent to other zoos or the zoos that their parents came from. Hence, animals need not be removed from the wild when new zoos open. So far, the Singapore Zoo has bred a long list of endangered animals including orangutans, white rhinos, multiple breeds of tigers and many more. So why close zoos when it benefits and brings protection and life to the animals?
Are you sure zoos benefit animals? Animals are not meant to be kept in cages and enclosures. They should be able to run free in the wild. Zoos may provide a safe environment for the animals, but the animals are not actually free. In such restricted and enclosed environments, it's much easier for diseases to be contracted among them. An example is the panda, which originates from China, which has a much cooler climate compared to Singapore. When placed in a climate like Singapore, with a completely different ecosystem and microorganisms in the air, the changes in condition might prove detrimental for the pandas. If you really care about the animals and their population, it will be much more humane to let them be free in the environment that they were meant to be living in naturally. For example, in aquariums, captive sharks will literally commit suicide by starving themselves to end their misery of being enclosed in a tiny space compared to the large expanse of the ocean, where it should be. Every animal should live wherever they want to in their own environment, where they are meant to be. Zoos keep animals in captivity, making animals in zoos practically prisoners. How would you feel if you were contained in an area until you die?
Sure, animals are not meant to be held in enclosures and kept away from the wild. However, you cannot deny that we are helping the animals out by conserving their species and providing a safe and conducive environment for animals to live in and reproduce. In addition, you may say that animals thrive better in their natural habitat. But I would like to remind you that with the great urbanization of the world, cities and businesses continue to tap into resources like the Amazon rainforest, a home to over 10 million species of flora and fauna. Deforestation takes away what used to be their homes, and if you think about it, zoos aren't the ones that are denying animals of their natural habitat. Humans are.
Another reason on why zoos should not be closed is that zoos are one of the only places where the public can view wildlife, either for study or even for fun. Do you not recall when you were in primary school? Every student had the chance to go to the zoo in the form of a learning journey. Even Singapore's education system recognizes the importance of exposing children to the beauty of our world by making learning journeys as such an integral part of our education. In addition, the public can also get to view wildlife, a privilege that we very much take for granted. Tell me, when is the last time you went out for a walk and saw a tiger on the loose? Without zoos, we would not be as educated about the world outside our concrete jungle as we are now. Zoos are a source of income and joy for us all, enchanting us by the beauty of wildlife when we go there. So in conclusion, Roy and I disagree to the closure of zoos as they provide a second chance for animals whose homes have been taken away from them to live and thrive in a safe environment.
Okay, I understand that animals do entertain humans, and I too have had a lot of fun at the zoo with my friends. However, have you ever considered how inhumane getting animals to perform for you is? Animals don't exist to entertain humans. Not only is that terribly egocentric, but downright disrespectful to the animals. In Thailand, zookeepers gain control over the elephants in zoos by breaking their spirit from young. They chain these baby elephants to poles, branches, columns, etc. And as a young baby elephant, they are unable to break free as they are too weak. Hence, as they grow up to become an adult elephant, they don't even bother trying to break free, even though they are more than strong enough to break free from these chains. After having this mentality, they are then pushed into slavery, where they are forced to clear logs during deforestation, or even forced to give rights to humans at zoos. Many tourists only see the front part of zoos, the fun that they all have out of riding the elephants, but they hardly see this negative side of what the zookeepers do to the animals. Hence, the only way to stop this is to shut down the zoos completely and prevent other zoos from continuing these very disrespectful and inhumane practices. This will stop cruelty towards animals and will ensure that they provided a natural and proper upbringing as all animals should deserve and should have.
So, throughout the debate, we have defended and supported our views and opinions. Sure, zoos may be conserving wildlife and beneficial to wildlife on paper by having breeding programs for endangered species like the white rhinos. However, it's really inhumane to limit their freedom by keeping them in enclosures or cages. It really affects the animals physically and mentally, as they are not meant to be kept in isolation from their peers in the wild. Another point mentioned was zoos being a place for the public to view wildlife and a source for jobs of us humans. It also allows humans to treasure wildlife and capture the essence of nature, something us humans should not be able to experience if not for zoos. However, the nature of animals kept for view or entertainment is remorseless towards the animals and not ideal for them. Sure, we may enjoy the presence of animals in zoos. However, do the animals enjoy our presence in return? As much as you guys may think zoos are great and beneficial to us, they are harmful towards animals and selfish of us to indulge ourselves with animals being entertainment and ignore the welfare of them. However, we feel that the most important thing about this is to patronize responsible zoos, only going to zoos that are respectful to animals.
Wait, what do
you
have to say?
Thank you for your kind attention.
Okay.
Okay, done.
Sai Pro.
Sai Pro is in